two tables for negation, conjunction, and disjunction. First, we put the symbolic symbol for each of these. Negation first. Negation has the wavy symbol. We had a summary from the previous section. This conjunction means and. It should be like capital letter A. And this junction is your or, which is the opposite of conjunction. So we will flip that sign. It's like a V shape. So I'll put the English language equivalent here. Negation is not. Conjunction means and. Disjunction means or. And then the truth tables. For negation, we have this truth table. So if you're given with P as the symbolic logic, the outcome would be not P. Now, there are only two conditions here, true, and the other one is false. So if my P is true, it says not P in the second column, it means you take the complement or the opposite of true, that would be false. And the other state for our first column here would be false. So just take the opposite of that, same as the first one. So this becomes true because it's not P. And that's the not truth table. Okay, for conjunction. So on the first column, we have P, and then we have Q. And then the outcome would be P and Q. So when you're writing the truth table, just look at the number of inputs you have here. So you have P, Q, so that's two. So that's 2 power of 2, so you're supposed to create 4 possible outcomes and 4 possible outputs also. So when you're constructing the truth table again, the formula would be 2 power of n. So n here is the number of inputs. So here, we have 2 power of 2, so that's why we got 4. So if I'm going to label this, I have here 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 possible combinations. So if you start with the second column, you go for T, F, T, F, alternate. And then going to the left on the first column, you will say T, 2 T's, and then 2 F's. Okay, and then in here, conjunction, only true when both statements are true. So that would be T here, and then the rest would be false. Okay. And then for the OR, do the same format of the table. So you will have four possible combinations here. Okay, so we have B here, Q, and then the symbol now is P or Q for the out. Again, let me label this. You have this as your inputs. And here would be your output. Okay, so let's put the possible combinations. So you start with the second column, start with T, and it alternates. And then on the first column, the P column, you're going to have T, T, and F, F. If you have more than four rows or four possible combinations, so this will alternate also. So the next possible combination will be T, T, then followed by F, F again. So here for this junction, you're going to say all only false when both statements are false. So that would be here. Again, only false when both statements are false. And the rest would be T. Okay, so those are the three basic truth tables: negation, conjunction, and disjunction. So let's try an example. Okay, using those truth tables. So you're going to ask to construct a truth table for this expression. Okay. You have to look at here. So this is a wavy symbol, so that would be the not P or Q, then and, then not Q. Okay, so you have to look at how many inputs you have here. So you're looking at two letters, so let's label that. You have P and Q. So the formula is 2 power 2, it gives you 4 possible ways or possible combinations. So we will construct that P, Q, and then 4 possible combinations. So let's start with the inputs. Inputs will, you start with the second column, starts with T, and then F, T, F. On the first column, on the first column, you're going to start with T, but two T's here, and then it alternates. Next would be two F's. And then let's evaluate what's inside the parenthesis, and the inner part would be the not P here. So we will take not P here. Okay, so when you see not P, you're looking at only the column P, which is the first column. And it is not P, it means you take the opposite of the given input. So if you have T there on the first one, it gives you F. And then you have F, because that's T. And going to the third row, it's F, the opposite is T, and the same thing with the last one, still T, because the given is F. Okay. And next, we will evaluate what is not P or Q. So this is the one inside the grouping symbol parenthesis here. So we're working from the inside going outside. So that's the inner part. So extend the truth table. And then get the answer for that. So when you see not P, you're looking at this column, and you're looking at the second column. So it's the third column and the second column, and you're using or disjunction in this case. So if you remember, OR would be false if only all the inputs would be false. So let's look at that for the second and the third column. So that would be false here on the second row, and then the rest would be true. So that's the definition of disjunction. So again, it's going to be false when all inputs would be false. Okay, and let's extend the truth table. And on the next column, you're looking at another term or another expression. So we can have here the not Q. So not Q here. When you see not Q, you're just looking at the second column and take the opposite of this. So the first row said T, so that would be F here. F on the second row, that would be T, the opposite. The third one is T, that would be F, to take the opposite. And then the last row would be F as the input, then that would be the opposite of F, then you will have a T. Okay. And the last one is, we're going to evaluate all of them. So the whole expression, we're trying to evaluate. So we're going to enter that, not P or Q, and not Q. Okay, so evaluating the whole expression, you're just looking at the fifth column, and you're looking at the fourth column to evaluate for or evaluate for your AND. So our operation here is, you're looking at this symbol, which is AND. So let me repeat that, the fourth column and the fifth column. So that would be your inputs for your AND now. Okay, so answers would be you're looking at AND. When you say AND, remember the definition. If all the inputs would be true, that's the time the output would be true. So just look for that combination. So you're looking at this part. You have TT, so it means you will get T here. Because you have only true when all the inputs for AND would be true. So given those two inputs are true, therefore the output is true. And the rest would be F. Again, F stands for false, T stands for true. And this is our final answer. So that's the truth table for the expression given. And our answer would be the last column. And the case here is to memorize the symbols and the truth tables for each. The truth table for negation, the truth table for conjunction, and the truth table for disjunction. Plus, you need to know how many possible combinations you have to construct. So we have four here because the formula would be 2 raised to the power of 2 over 4. So if you have PQR, that should be 2 power of 3, then you will create 8 possible combinations in that case.